Hey everyone, this is Nick from Mecca Warehouse, and today we're back with weekly update number 127. So let's jump right into it with week in review. This is where I talk about what's been going on in the warehouse, things that are coming up, stuff like that. And I guess first off, this past Sunday I went to ValleyCon down in Chicopee, Mass. Ethan tagged along with the camera. Patrick actually came with us this time too, and it was a good show. We had a good time. I got silver for my Dom R35. Patrick entered a couple builds and ended up with a bronze for, I think, his YF19 and a silver for his RG Wing Zero. So congrats, Patrick. It was a good show though. Saw a lot of good builds. Overall, the quality of the builds, I think, came up from last year, which is awesome to see. And it seemed like builds shifted more towards painted, customized builds from the other category, because the show has two categories. They've got, for Gundam, they've got kind of customized painted, and then they've got like beginner, unpainted, primarily more like snap builds that are panel lined, things like that. So good to see that kind of shift to the more advanced category and see the overall quality kind of improve. Had some great conversations with people. It was a good show and a good time. Looking forward to the next one. Next up, we do have a bunch of restocks. We've taken the restock section out of the video, so we won't be posting what they are in the weekly update, but there are a bunch of solid restocks this week, so definitely check that out. And we've got a bunch more coming over the next, I don't know, week or two probably, bunch of shipments, just all like the floodgates opened up, the kink in the hose is open for these bunch of shipments that we were working on. So they're all on the way. We got some Kotobukiya, we got some good Bandai stuff coming, and a few other, we'll say third party, other manufacturers that I don't even know what's coming yet. I saw the credit card charge and I haven't seen the invoice yet. So there's definitely a bunch of stuff coming over the next few weeks, which will be exciting. Speaking of exciting, this week, or last week rather, Bandai announced a bunch of new releases. We put out a video on Tuesday, just kind of going through all the releases. So if you're curious what's coming out, definitely check that out. I will note though, we had a minor snafu with some of the overlays in the text where they weren't right, typos and some copy and paste errors and stuff like that. So if you're looking at any of those and you're questioning which is accurate, I think with like 90 something percent certainty, what I'm saying is the accurate part and it's the overlay that's wrong. Just in case you're curious. On that same note, though, I would like to talk about pre-orders. We don't usually take our pre-orders till we get confirmations. With the whole BNTCA issue that we had earlier this year, we don't currently know where we're going to get all of our pre-order stuff from, all our new releases and things like that. I've got a call scheduled for this afternoon with one distributor, and I'm working on conversations with several others to try to determine which ones will make sense, who's going to help us get the allocations we need. Once we get those issues kind of hammered out, we'll be in a more confident place to offer pre-orders. We likely won't offer pre-orders until they confirm what they're getting from BNTCA, because once they get those confirmations and if they're promising to deliver what they've promised us, we should be in a pretty good place to offer pre-orders. And as per usual, it might be several months from now before we're able to offer pre-orders for, say, the RG Epion. Assuming everything comes together and we get all those confirmations and get everything figured out, we will be trying to offer pre-orders for those new releases. So keep an eye out for that. We'll try to update you as the weeks and months pass and we get closer to that. A couple other quick things. One, we are playing with the idea of doing a mystery box challenge, a blind box challenge, where we're going to get a bunch of a kit. You won't know what it is. You'll pay to enter basically, and we'll ship that kit to everybody who's entered, and everybody will build the same kit for the contest. got some good ideas. We're working with Kotobukiya. It's probably gonna be a Kotobukiya kit. Working with them on prize support. We're working on figuring out all the details and all of that. But keep an eye out, because we'll hopefully be announcing that in a few weeks once we get all the details hammered out. And I think it'll be a fun contest to have everybody trying to build the same kit and see what they can do with it, and kind of showcase their talents and creativity in taking that one kit and kind of telling a story with it, or bringing it to life in some other way than just snapping it together. It should be exciting. We're also getting really close for the 2023 coin. I'm just hammering out the final details on the coin right now with the coin manufacturer. We got the first proof. There are a few minor changes that we're hoping to figure out. And once all that stuff's hammered out, then we'll be offering that on the Discord. So if you're not familiar, we do have a Discord challenge coin. This will be our fourth year doing it. You have to be a Discord member to get one. They're individually serial numbered. They have a really cool set of artwork, different artwork each time. And so if you want one, you gotta be a member of the Discord, and we'll release more details once we have that finalized and we're ready to do that. So I think that's it for Week in Review. Let's move on to pre-orders. We had two new pre-orders this week, both from Kotobukiya, and these are both kits that we kind of missed before with our other distributor. They just didn't have enough, or we didn't get our order in time. Sometimes those order cycles are really weird for some of these other distributors for Kotobukiya stuff for us. So Kotobukiya directly still had some available, so we were able to secure some. So one is the Megami Device AUV Amaterasu Regalia. So it's a Megami Device kit, you know, another girl kit. And then the other is the Frame Arms Girl Hresfilger Albus. Probably mispronouncing that, but so if you're into Frame Arms, Megami Device, stuff like that, definitely worth checking both of those out. Really happy to be able to get them and be able to get them direct through Kotobukiya. That means they'll be here sooner. So that's it for pre-orders. Let's move on to Team Picks. So Team Picks is the portion where we're basically asking members of the team here about, you know, kits that they've built, kits that we should have in stock at least currently, and get kind of the lowdown on what they liked, didn't like, stuff like that. So let's do that.
So this week I brought in the YF-19 from Macross Plus, the new kit that just came out from Bandai. I built it last week so that I could take it to the IPMS event that we went to over the weekend. Check out that video. This new kit, the engineering is just phenomenal on it. The transformations are very nice. The kit went together really easy. The only downside really on this one is the stickers. While they're better than the old school Bandai stickers, they're still stickers.
I chose the Gray Notchin this week because I've been meaning to buy one since we got them like a year and a half ago. I really like the build. It has a lot of customizing parts. You can give it like a little dark gray head, or you can continue with the light gray. It is really customizable. It has like all these little ports around it where you can take them off and put like any 3mm part into it and really kind of expand on the look. If I had one complaint about it, it would be the kind of like the hand and arm articulations. I kind of wish the hands bent a little bit more so I could have it grab things outside its own weapons.
All right, so that was Team Picks. Let's move on to Q&A. So this is where I answer questions from you, the viewer. If you have a question you want answered, post it down in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer it for next week. Let's jump right into it. So first up, Plastic Germs. Question, with the new direct Kotobukiya account, what things will you remember from BNTCA while dealing with Kotobukiya? Honestly, most of the issues we've had with BNTCA regarding just dealing with them already appear to not be an issue with Kotobukiya. We haven't received a shipment from them yet, so there's gonna be a whole bunch of stuff there that, you know, we'll find out, I guess, when we get there. We haven't placed an in-stock order yet with them, but we're going to very, very soon. I think, one, just asking the right questions and keeping an eye on any distributor. This is an issue we have with pretty much anybody is, you know, do they cancel orders without telling you? Do they communicate what's going on? So far hasn't been an issue with Kotobukiya, so hopefully it won't be an issue, but you'll never know, I guess. those are the kinds of things that we've learned to kind of watch out for. BNTCA is kind of infamous for, we'd get a list of everything that we had had orders for, and some things would just drop off the list, and we wouldn't know why. We would have to go and reach out and communicate with them about it. So looking for those kinds of things. Fun question. What is one thing you always remember when you were a child while being with your parents? I think you asked this last week. I probably shot an answer to it. It probably got cut because it was a pretty weak answer. I think we got less questions this week, so I'll try to answer it again. And it probably won't get cut because there's just less questions. But it's hard to say. Like, I don't feel like there's any, like, one memory. I've got plenty of good memories with my family, with my parents, stuff like that. But there's nothing that's like, oh, this is the one thing I'll never forget. Perhaps the, you know, I feel like I have probably a ton of memories from vacations and stuff like that, you know, doing whatever particular thing, going on a certain ride or dealing with a certain issue while on vacation with my family. I don't know if those stand out because they're a different environment than just the day-to-day at the house and stuff like that. So I guess that's kind of my answer. Hopefully that's good enough. Next up, the time sink question. Given your background in engineering, what kit featured a whoa, that's cool moment for you? That's a good question. There's a lot of kits that have really cool features, really cool gimmicks, really cool design stuff. I'd say probably one of them, though, that jumps out the most, I think, is the Master Grade Tall Geese. And the, I guess they're the binders or the boosters that go in the back, and the feature where you can like pull them apart and then the thrusters all open up, and the mechanical design in there to have it kind of articulate based on one piece moving and articulating everything else. I think that was one of the coolest, like, wow, look at this engineering. But I think there's a lot of amazing features about a lot of kits, and they don't feel as amazing because they've become common because you see them all the time. But like any time that they do runners where they're molding multiple colors of plastic together, or they're molding hands that you just, like some of the real grades and master grade hands, the articulating ones, where you cut them off the runner and you essentially just move the joints and everything just kind of comes together. Like from an engineering perspective, that's kind of incredible. But we see it pretty frequently now, so it's really cool, but it's also like common, if that makes sense. I think we got one more question, Plastic Crack 305. Hey Nick, I have a question. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the action figure line, but either way, will Mecha Warehouse at some point be carrying Acid Rain World and Joy Toy action figures with the Mechs and Pilots, Diorama parts, and accessories? Great question. When it comes to anything figure, action figure, statue, etc., we've carried some of that stuff in the past, and we're moving away from it right now. Will we carry it in the future? The answer is, you know, never say never. We might at some point branch into that. We've found that with our current customer base, they don't perform as well. And until we're ready to start trying to go after the customer base that's really interested in that stuff. Of course, there's some overlap between Gunpla and figures and stuff like that, but they're not the same audience. There's a Venn diagram or whatever, and that intersection is great, but until we're ready to go after that other circle, we probably won't carry a lot of that stuff. Diorama supplies and accessories, I feel like that might happen sooner. I've been getting into diorama building myself the last month or two, so I think it might be cool to carry some of that stuff, if only to scratch my own itch and have those supplies available on the shelf when I need more of them. But I don't even know with that when or how much we'll carry, because I'm not sure what that overlap is, but we will probably start playing around with that at some point in the coming, you know, months or so, sometime later this year maybe. So hopefully that answers your question. So thank you all for your questions. If you have a question you want answered, like I said before, post it down in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer it next time. Thank you for watching. See you next time.